ये इवेंट काफ़ी बड़ा इवेंट है इंस्टीट्यूट के लिए, जो दो दिन का कॉर्पोरेट फोरम रहता है। एक हमारा 18 जनवरी और 19 जनवरी दो दिन का इवेंट है। आज पूरा दिन एक कॉन्फ्रेंस चली प्राइवेट इक्विटी के ऊपर, और शाम को हमने बिजनेस फोरम रखा है जहाँ पे एंटरप्रेनर टॉक है कि हाउ यू कैन बिकम ए एंटरप्रेनर और उसमें क्या डिफ़िकल्टीज आती हैं। ये मोटिवेशन टॉक है। हम चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट जो केवल प्रैक्टिस में रहते हैं या हम लोग जॉब में रहते हैं, उनके लिए एक नई सोच है कि नई सोच बढ़ के हम आगे बढ़ें और एक नया अपना ऊपर इंटरप्रेनर थॉट प्रोसेस करके अपना धंधा खुद का चालू कर सकें, उसके लिए एक बिज़नेस फोरम रखा है। हमारे चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट काफ़ी बिज़नेस के अंदर हैं, तो उनके लिए एक सोचा है कि भाई बिज़नेस में हैं तो और भी लोग आगे बिज़नेस बढ़ें, तो उसके लिए एक बिज़नेस फोरम आयोजित किया गया है। ये एक अच्छा, कल हमारा अवार्ड फंक्शन है, कल सुबह प्राइवेट कैपिटल मार्केट पर सेमिनार है, फिर शाम को अवार्ड फंक्शन रखा है। तो जितने लीडर्स हैं जो चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट में काफ़ी बड़े बड़े लीडर्स हैं, उनको अवार्ड दिया जाएगा। जूरी की प्रोसेस होती है, उस प्रोसेस में पास करके एक क्रेडिबल अवार्ड हम लोग देते हैं। ये 12वां साल है और काफ़ी बड़े बड़े लोगों को अवार्ड उसमें मिलने वाला है। दीपक पारिक जैसे लोगों को लाइफ टाइम अचीवमेंट अवार्ड मिल रहा है, तो एक बहुत बड़ी एक शख्सियत है और ये एक बहुत बड़ा एक अवार्ड है और चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट का फिल्म फेयर अवार्ड है ये। अनन्या बिरला इज अ यूथ आइकॉन एज ऑफ नाउ, ऑल द यंगस्टर लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड ऑन हर, पीपल वांटेड कि हम उनको सुनना चाहते हैं। आज यूथ आइकॉन है, आज ये मीडिया की तरह रखा है, आज जी बिजनेस इसको रिलीज करेगा या आप लोग रिलीज करोगे, उससे एक मैसेज पूरे सी ए फर्टर्निटी में जाएगा, ये स्टूडेंट फर्टर्निटी में जाएगा। जो चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं, वो जो आगे आने वाली पीढ़ी है, वो देखती है कि हमको भी किस तरीके से करना है, नेम एंड फ्लेम एंड ग्लैमर तीनों को समित कैसे कर सकते हैं। तो आज चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट भी हर फील्ड में जा रहा है, तो वो भी देखता है कि हम फाइनेंस फील्ड में उसको आगे कैसे बढ़ सकते हैं, ये मोटिवेशन मिलेगा। एक इधर
थैंक यू वेरी मच। जैसे अपना चेयरमैन साहब ने बोले कमिटी फॉर मेंबर्स इंडस्ट्री का, मिस्टर धीरज खंडेलवाल, कि हम लोग चाहते हैं कि अपना जो मेंबर्स है, जो चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स है, वो द लेटेस्ट क्या हो रहा है देश में, इकोनॉमी कहाँ है, इसी इंडस्ट्री कैसा ग्रोथ कर रहा है, कैसा बढ़ रहा है, हम लोग चाहते हैं कि अपना चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट मेंबर्स लोग सब जाने। तो इसलिए हम लोग इस तरह से बिज़नेस फोरम अरेंज किए हैं। तो और कल में जैसे धीरज ने बोला, राजेश जी भी वाइस चेयरमैन है इस कमेटी का, तो कल में हम लोग अचीवर्स को हम लोग अवार्ड दे रहे हैं। तो ये एनुअल प्रोग्राम है इंस्टीट्यूट का, हर एक साल हम लोग करते हैं। तो और हम लोग हर एक साल बहुत बड़े पैमाने में करते हैं, वी गेट बेटर एंड बेटर एवरी ईयर। सो आई एम श्योर सी एवरीबडी हु इज़ अटेंडिंग दिस प्रोग्राम विल बेनिफिट वेरी मच।
मैं ये कहना चाहूँगा, चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स जिस भी फील्ड में काम किया है उन्होंने महारत हासिल करी है। अगर आप देश के अंदर में मंत्रियों को देख लें तो बहुत अच्छे लेवल पे हैं, अगर किसी को भी देख लें, चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट अगर एज ए एंटरप्रेन्योर है तो बहुत अच्छे लेवल पे पहुंच जाता है। तो चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट जिन लोगों ने महारत हासिल करी है, जिन्होंने इंडस्ट्रीज़ को एक लेवल तक पहुँचाया है, वैसे चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स को कलाम अवार्ड दे रहे हैं और उनको एक अलग लेवल तक पहुँचाने के लिए उनका जो देश के प्रति कंट्रीब्यूशन है उसको हम अवार्ड कर रहे हैं और इंडस्ट्री के प्रति जो कंट्रीब्यूशन है उसको हम अवार्ड कर रहे हैं।
My dad is a CA and I have heard how tough it is, but how amazing it is as well, how much it supports you in life. It's an absolute pleasure for me to be here today as chief guest, and I look forward to meeting with everyone and going up and talking for a few minutes as well. So it's an absolute pleasure for me to be here.
I think it's, I'm speechless, you know, she's a youth icon. Every in the institute is you know, looking from last 2 years, you know, everyone wanted to be here as a chief guest. Now it's the day come for me. It's like I'm really very thankful for the, you know, Ananya to be here. It's the right, really nice. It's the right now she is a youth icon. Everyone, you know, there's a forum, is a business forum, and it is meant for, you know, for the becoming an entrepreneur. So it's a right people and right time.
Very, very kind. Thank you.
It's already released.
Yeah. So, गाने के बारे में, it's called Better. अभी कल रात 12 बजे रिलीज हुआ, आज सुबह. Right now, it's doing really well. It's trending on Gaana, Wing, Hangama, Jio Saavn, Apple Music. It's everywhere. India has been so kind to me. Thank you, all of you. I just went live on Instagram right now just to thank all the fans out there. 2019 is a वेरी नाइस ईयर, वेरी बहुत बहुत बढ़िया साल है मेरे लिए. एल्बम आ रहा है और म्यूजिक वीडियोज़ आ रहे हैं, लॉट ऑफ सपोर्ट इंटरनेशनली एज वेल, सो एब्सोल्यूट प्लेजर.
व्हाट डू यू हैव टू से अबाउट द इनिशिएटिव आईसीआई यूजुअली गेट्स इनटू व्हेन देयर इज
Yes, so I heard about the app that you all are creating, the CA Jobs. I think it's absolutely amazing. I think that's what India needs. I think it also encourages more people to take up CA and study the course. And I think the course is very, very essential for business, especially amongst other things. Of course, it teaches hard work and discipline as well, like my dad says, and I've seen it. So it encourages people because they know that after, you know, doing a CA, they have somewhere to go to get a good job. One more avenue to sort of, you know, look forward to. So absolutely great stuff, and it's a great community to bring people together. Like every single CA I know knows about ICAI, knows about what it's for, and everyone I've said says, wow, you're there, congratulations. So it's a pleasure for me to be here, and I think all the work that ICAI does is absolutely amazing.
We have Mika performing tomorrow, so,
okay.
You know, so there's an inspiration of music, so what do you have to say about that? You know, a cultural activity for...
Music makes me better. So I think music entertainment is a very important part of all our lives. We have to put our hair down, have fun. And I'm so glad Mika is coming tomorrow. I think he's going to make all of y'all really have a good time. So have a blast.
Neeraji, what is your concluding note? What is the message that you would like to give out?
I think it's a great evening today, and I think on behalf of the entire CA community, CA Parivar, we want to thank to the Ananya to be gracing this occasion. So it's amazing. Thank you.
Thank you. My pleasure.
So you are in the center, you are in the camera.
The cost of capital in China is, I would say, as cheap as you.
Guest, the today chief guest, Ananya Birla ji, my all central council colleague, my vice chairman Rajesh Sharma ji, the sponsor, and another guest of honor Jayant Maheshkar ji, and all, say for me it's a dream come true. She is the youth icon and motivator, and people look forward, basically the youngster look forward, a thought processor, a follower, that we wanted to be a entrepreneur. She is today is an entrepreneur and going to be a chief guest today, and I'm very, very happy to seeing over here in this Chartered Accountant Forum. Her father is a chartered accountant, none other than Kumar Mangala Birla ji. Ma'am, this is the committee for member in industries and business, which take care of the industry people and the business people. We used to take care of the campus placement program. We did twice a year campus placement program. This time we did more milestone on this campus placement. We did campus placement for the experienced chartered accountant. We did placement for overseas campus placement. Today we are having a campus placement for semi-qualified people. We also launched the job portal on 31st August, and we started the startup activities, startup funding, and idea placement, Shark Tank contest, and incubation centers. We already started all the new thought process arena, which you also been on that path. And ma'am, this tomorrow is award function. This is going to 12th award function. We started in 2007 to recognize the leader of the industries, those reached to the heights like your dad, Kumar Mangala Birla ji. Tomorrow we going to have the lifetime achievement award for the Deepak Parikh ji, and lot of, you know, top dignitaries who had got this award is from the prestigious ICAI body. It's a prestigious ICAI body, and which are recognizing the members their own. So it's like a from the film fraternity, is the ICAI Film Fraternity Award. It's
overwhelming. Thank you so much. Firstly, thank you so much to ICAI for having me here today. It's an absolute pleasure for me, actually. My dad is a CA,
And I know how he said those were some of his toughest years, but some of his best years as well. Recently, I found out that he failed his first year, which I didn't know. But then the next time when he passed with a very high grade. So I know how amazing the journey can be and is, and how tough it is as well. So I look up to all of you sitting here who have qualified, because I think it takes a lot of discipline. When I started microfinance, I remember I came home and I told my mom, "Mom, I want to start a microfinance company." And my mom was looks at me and she's like, "Beta, what is microfinance?" And since then, there was absolutely no looking back. So it took a year for me to actually get the NBFC MFI license. I think all of you all must be remembering around 2009, 2010, there was this huge MFI crisis in AP, where the entire market was blacklisted, and you know, it created a big havoc. However, at that time itself, also I realized that there was no fault in the model, but the problem was just because of political reasons. And so I didn't hesitate in taking it up in any way. And my dad, of course, as usual, was very supportive and said, "Now there's no looking back once you have gotten into it." And that was why I founded Swatantra. Initially, my struggles. Like everyone else at the age of 17, microfinance, well, I was 17, everyone else in the industry were in the late 50s, early 60s, and I was a 17-year-old girl. Who would possibly take me seriously? They used to say, "Birla ki beti hai, to aaram se aa jayega." But they didn't really realize that there's a huge struggle that goes behind it as well. So somehow I somehow managed to talk to a couple of VCs, talk to a couple of different people, and I raised 5 crores, because that's what the mandate was to get an NBFC MFI license. You needed 5 crores of capital. So remember, I got exact 5 crores, and that's when I started. It was very tough to get clients in, was very, very tough to get a team in, 17-year-old, and that to a woman. How is she going to do this? What is she going to do? How is she going to manage this? Microfinance? No way, not possible. But I didn't give up. There was no way I was going to give up. And since then, I have not given up. So currently, we are in 10 states. We have 2 million women as clients. And we have just touched a GLP of 1,000 crores. And thank you so much. And by 2022, we will be a million-dollar company. And it feels very surreal to stand here and say this, because I know that me and my team have completely started from absolute scratch, from literally typing down the SOPs, you know, to handpicking every single team member who comes in, to really, you know, looking at cash flows in detail, putting the MIS together. Typical startup. I say, as a startup, you're CEO and CPO, chief exec officer and chief plumbing officer, both. Same time. So that was exactly what it was for me. So it feels very nice thinking that we have reached where we have. So that's basically been my journey where Swatantra is concerned. I think a couple of things that I have learned through this journey. One is that I think y'all will agree with me, it's very important to have the right vision and a clear vision, because if you don't know what you want to achieve, then everything will become a mess. If you are very clear in your head as to what you want to achieve and where you want to get, it'll trickle down throughout the team. And once the entire team is aligned, once the entire team knows what it is that you want to achieve, that is when emotional equity starts building, and that is when everyone comes together in the various departments, comes together to achieve that one goal. So having a very clear vision is very, very important. Because that's when emotional equity starts building in. It's very, very important, I have also learned, that everyone in your core team needs to be very, very, very emotionally engaged, not just within you, but within the vision. Because then during stressful times, during times of they may get other job opportunities, during times of when there's not enough liquidity in the market, during tough times, that is what will make people stick on. That is what will make you want to stay on with your team, with the organization, is emotional equity. And especially with a startup, this is what happens. You've started everything right from the beginning, and you have a group of people with you. So they feel like, and you feel like, this is my baby. I feel like Swatantra is my baby, however cliche that sounds. we have grown up together. Swatantra, in a sense, I feel has made me Swatantra. It's given me wings to become absolutely free. So having a right and clear vision and transcending that down to your team and ensuring that your team has a lot of emotional equity within you is very, very important. Another thing is your target group. Very important to know who your target group is and why and for what you're targeting them. And the next thing, of course, very important is market differentiation. What are you providing that no one else in the market is providing? Now, a huge, I can go on and on about this point because it's a very, very large point that is, you know, there in theory as well. And practically, I've learned a lot about this as well. But I think one thing that has really defined us, and I think many people, is innovation. Do you all agree with me? I think innovation is a huge, 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 huge part of market differentiation, especially in today's day and age, where everything is about content, 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 content. It's almost like it's too much. You don't know what to consume where. Everything's about data. Everything's content. You have to differentiate yourself. How do you differentiate yourself? How do you provide the best possible solutions to your clients? How do I possibly provide the best possible financial solutions in the cheapest way to my clients? How do I become the one-stop place where all my clients just want to come to Swatantra and we can give them the best possible services in a qualitative and quantitative manner? Everyone is doing it. How do I do it better? Innovation. How do I innovate? Now, depending upon your business and depending upon your business model, it would, of course, change. The thought process that I personally used. What's the biggest problem that the market is facing? At that stage, it was NPAs. NPAs were way too high. What was happening, the field officers were actually carrying loads and loads and loads, lakhs and lakhs of money on their bags from the client's home to the center, back to the client's home, back to the center, to the headquarters. Now, the probability of the bag being stolen, them being on bikes, is very, very high. Companies would lose lakhs and lakhs of money just in that. So the first thing I did was I went completely cashless. I ensured that every single client of ours opened a bank account. If they didn't have an account, we opened a bank account for them. So there we encouraged saving as well. If you save money in our savings account, you get 3% return on this as well. We directly have a direct transfer of that amount into their bank. We do not work in cash at all. And in the same way, we used to have backdated checks and now we don't because everything is real time. They repay their EMIs to us through bank transfers as well. That's the first thing. The second thing we did is we went completely paperless. So right from KYC to client information, KYC to actually having to scan their Aadhaar card so that all the information comes in, to having the disbursement sheets, to seeing whether they come into the criteria, whether they're eligible clients or not, what sort of assets they have, how liquid they are, everything, their photos, every single thing is documented on this one app, which is called Saathi. And Swatantra happens to be the first microfinance institution that actually has a complete turnkey product which makes our processes and our SOPs completely cashless and paperless. So that has helped us immensely. That has made us a very big player in the market now. And I never thought this day would come. A 17-year-old with zero clients, with no one wanting to join their team, to now being a very, very important part of the MFI industry. Our COO and, well, my CEO happens to be the chairperson of MFIN as well now. So the game has really changed, and I think a lot of this change has been because of the innovation that we sort of came up with, which was Saathi, which is just, like I said, completely ensures that your processes are completely cashless and paperless, and it's just all on our field officers' mobile phones. So it didn't take that much. It was in-house, full of algorithms, took at least 3 years to build. But now that it's completely built, the magic that it has created, not just for us, but for our field officers, for our clients, it's been absolutely amazing. Yield has gone up, which means stat has gone down, which means progress as a whole has gone up. GLP has increased absolutely exponentially. Our CAGR has also increased absolutely exponentially. We grew by 324% CAGR, which was the fastest growing company, microfinance company last year. So I can vouch that innovation to solve a certain issue, problem, teething problem in your organization, using innovation to solve that would be a big, big way in which you could personally differentiate your product from your competitors. So that's pretty much been my journey with Swatantra. I realized through this journey that I personally absolutely love startups. It's like from nothing at all, you build something really beautiful and you actually start impacting people's lives. And seeing a smile on our clients' face is something that is just such a rewarding feeling. I remember one client, just to give you an instance, she has a salon, very, very small, probably one third of this stage. And she just had one mirror and one chair where ladies used to come to do their eyebrows or, you know, their nails, etc., etc. It was a salon. And she said, mujhe loan chahiye, blah, blah, blah. You know, we had a long discussion. Field officers, this was very, very initially. She was one of our, I think, first 10 clients. Now when I go back, her place is probably thrice the size of this stage. She has employed at least 15 more women. And the demand for, she's become the most demanding, you know, salon in that entire Sarpanch area. So to see that progress happen for her in the last 3 years, is just very, very heartwarming. And Swatantra has not helped in any way. The lady has absolutely repaid us, not just principal, but with interest. So we are just there to support them. They help themselves. So whenever anyone comes up to me and says that you're helping so many rural women, no, absolutely not. I do not believe in this at all. We're not helping anyone. We're just a part of their progress. We're just providing them the financial funding that they require. Just the way the VC gave me the 5 crores when I was 17. Yes, the amount is different, the reason is different, but it is absolutely the same thing. So these women are helping themselves. So that was